Hello, this is Bern, and if you intuitively feel that it's better to wait to know a man better before you have sex with him, but feel unsure around why this is the case or how to set the boundary in a high-value way, well, stick with me, because I'm going to share with you the answer to these two questions on my episode today. Hello, this is Bern. Welcome to your greatlifetb.com, a space where I share with ambitious, conscious, heart-centered and successful women how you can create the relationship of your dreams and attract the kind of man you want without the need for games or manipulation, and as a result of stepping into the most alive and feminine version of you. Now, the reason why I feel it's very important for you to say no or let's wait longer when a guy wants to have sex with you if it's early on in the relationship is because sex is a much bigger deal and a much riskier thing than we make it out to be sometimes. For many different reasons, from STDs to pregnancy to the fact that it's very, very hard for most human beings that I've connected with to really separate the emotional, the spiritual, and the physical aspects of something as deep and as intense as sex. Because there's biology involved, and because there's hormones involved, and because sometimes you get to develop a stronger attachment to a human being, many times, most times, than if you don't have sex with them. So the greatest vulnerability and risk, my dear, if you're a woman listening to this, is to you. Why? Because you can get pregnant and he can't. Just based on that, should give you enough pause to know that if something goes wrong, you might be faced with a challenging situation for the rest of your life, and he doesn't have to deal with it necessarily. So that's dry. Am I saying it's fair? It's not fair, but it is what it is. That's the way it works right now. Because you stand to lose the most if you get pregnant, it's to your advantage to actually learn how to set this strong boundary if the guy is not thinking straight or wanting to go forward faster than you're ready for. So the next thing I'll say is that connecting and having sex with a guy for you can create a depth of emotional attachment through the rise of oxytocin and a few other chemicals in your system that will make you believe that you know this man more than you know him, and that you care about him more than you really care about him. And that attachment, if it's with the wrong guy, if you create that strong attachment and feeling of intense wanting to be with him and he is a bad guy for you, then that continuation of the sex is only making your life miserable. Because sooner or later, that man is going to show his true colors, or he's maybe showing them from the beginning and letting you know that he's not interested in the same vision that you have for your life, or he doesn't want commitment, or he doesn't want family, and here you are wasting valuable, amazing time with someone who's derailing you from getting exactly and everything that you want in a relationship. So that's one of the reasons why it's important to wait. Second one is because it's going to give you more objectivity, right, in your evaluation process. The more objective you are, the more you can gauge the friendship, the more you can gauge his real stance, not just the verbal communication, but the actions that follow the verbal communication, which actually show you what he's really about. His thoughts are going to be important because they show you the guy is conscious and self-aware. His actions will show you that he means what he says. And that continuation of action is something that you will be unlikely to evaluate if you feel more attached, which is part of the thing that I was discussing in the previous point. Next one is, so what are the minimal requirements in my mind? What should you wait for? How would you know that you're ready to connect with a guy, and how long will it take? Well, it's going to take different for different human beings. I would be willing to share this, that it doesn't matter how intense it feels at the beginning. Time will let you know that the risk is lower. Is there a chance that you can connect with a guy and have sex with him the first time you meet him and you end up marrying him for 75 years? That exists, but more likely than not, that's not how it's going to go for you. And giving yourself a time frame that's longer versus shorter will diminish the risk for you and let you know that the person that you're connecting with really has your best interests at heart, which is important when you open yourself to that level of depth with someone. So the minimal requirements I feel should be in place is, you know the man, he's consistently shown up in your life in a way that's beneficial to you and serving versus just taking. Here's a guy that you have a friendship with. It's a friend. You already develop a friendship with. You know more about him. You understand the vision for his life, and the vision for his life and the vision for your life are in alignment. You have secured, both of you have secured exclusivity, meaning he's not with anyone else, either sexually or emotionally. You're not with anyone else sexually or emotionally. And you can really open up to explore how far you can take this relationship, including marriage, right? So am I saying you have to be married till you do this? That's not my suggestion. I'm saying that you definitely want to be in an exclusive relationship. You want to be in a relationship that's reciprocal in nature. You want to be in a respectful relationship. You want to be in alignment in terms of vision for the future. And then the sex can have a deeper meaning, and the likelihood that you'll get hurt will reduce. Now, am I saying that that eliminates the chance of you getting hurt? No, but it's going to reduce it a lot more than probably what you've experienced in the past. Now, I get it, and many of you will say, but Bernd, you don't understand. Sex is so important in a relationship. So what if I waste all this time, connect with a guy, and then find out that we're not sexually compatible? Well, let me share with you two different scenarios. One scenario is that you invest time, you connect, you go deeper, you create friendship, and then when there's an exclusive relationship, you have sex and it's not as fulfilling as you imagined. At that stage of understanding, there is a possibility that you can work on the sex aspect of it, and it's a meaningful working together on it, and then it can get better. Am I saying for sure it'll get better? No, but there's a chance it can get better. Why? Because sex requires practice and requires that knowing of each other and your preferences and your tastes and your likes and your dislikes and the pleasure that each one of you experiences. It is possible for the sex to get better, even if it's not better at the beginning. Now, here's the opposite risk you would be taking. You don't know the guy that well. You have sex with him. He's an asshole towards you, but you feel super attached and you can let go of him. Of the two risks, the risk of risking, maybe you can it can get better, is significantly lower than now you're attached to this dude for 1 year or 2 years and your life is miserable in the process. So of the two risks, I say take the lower one, whichever one that feels to you. I'll say one more thing. Because a few of you are gonna say, Bern, you don't understand. Guys don't wanna wait. Well, my dear, let me tell you something. I am a guy and I fully understand that feeling of not wanting to wait. However, you will find three different categories of guys. One guy who's basically upfront with you and saying, I want to wait. I'm the one who wants to wait. That's probably gonna be the 5% of guys out there. Awesome if you find one that way, but not necessarily the one that you'll find more frequently. And there are gonna be two other groups of guys. The bulk of guys will fit into two categories. One will be, I don't like waiting, and I'm not gonna wait. Another one says, I don't like waiting, but I'm willing to wait. I'm willing to risk waiting because getting to know you is worth it. Developing something deeper is worth it. Delaying gratification is worth it, which basically the stance that you take, if you take it back, the stance that he's saying is, one guy is basically saying, I'm an overgrown child and I have to have it my fucking way right now or I'll throw a little tantrum. The other one says, I am a man, not a boy, and I can step into the principle of delayed gratification, meaning I can sacrifice the temporary fulfillment of something to get something deeper in the end. It's not just showing you that the guy is willing to wait for sex, it's also showing you that the guy is gonna be significantly higher value to his own life, to your life, and to society, okay? If you find this helpful, insightful, useful, I'm gonna ask you to do three things, my dear. Number one, click like or thumbs up on this video. Number two, subscribe to my channel. Number three, on the first link on the description of this video, click on the link, enter in my email, and I'll take you to a free masterclass that will show you how to step into the kind of relationship that I'm talking about right now. Now, if you are someone who's saying, Bern, I love the way you think, I really get this, and I want your specific help in finding myself, reconnecting to my courage, and finding that kind of partner that I haven't found yet in my life, then I'd love to figure out if I can help you. Fill out an application that's found on the second link under the description of this video. And if we're fit to work together, my assistant will reach out and set up a time to connect. Thank you so much for connecting with me. And as always, I challenge you, live a full and a conscious life.